So, as many of you know, I make animations. And today I'm gonna show you the basics of how I do these animations. At first I'm gonna explain the basic concept of keyframes, because some people are not familiar with them yet. A lot of people were wondering what app I'm using, and I use an app called Note Video. I'm just gonna show you the basic concept of animating with keyframes. So, if you look at this, this is a circle. And now I'm somehow gonna make it move. So if I tap on here, you can see keyframes. That basically means that at a certain time, the circle is at a certain place. And as you can see, there are no keyframes yet. So the circle is just there all the time, right in the middle. But now if I add a keyframe, that still changes nothing because the circle will just stay where it is. But what you need is another keyframe so the circle can move from one place to another place between those two frames. So maybe at maybe 2 seconds, if I add a keyframe there, and now I move the circle to the right, you can see that when I go back in time, circle will move to where it was at the other keyframe. So basically with these keyframes, you can tell the circle what to do in a certain amount of time. So when I play it, it just moves to the right. This is very basic and most people already know this. So let's move on. I just created some kind of pendant because I wanted to swing around. And what's important now is that you have a free background and you export it as PNG file. So the background can be free. And now that I have put it into my program, I can make it swing around. Here you can see the rotation, which means that it's gonna rotate. So if you change this here, it's gonna rotate, but this does not look like it's swinging around yet. Not quite. Because the center, it's swinging around this center here. So you have to take this little thing here and move it all the way up. So now if you rotate it, it swings like this. Let's add keyframes. Again, at around 2 seconds. The first keyframe is gonna be left. And it's gonna swing right. Now, if you watch it, it will swing. Of course, this is really slow. I'm just gonna adjust it a little. Now it's swinging around more times if you look at it. But it still looks kind of weird, right? In real life, objects don't move like this. At first, it's really slow, and then it gets faster, and then it's slow again. So how can you apply it to your animation? You just simply edit the curves. You can see this curve, which basically means it's the same speed from one point to another. I love to use this curve because it's really a really soft movement. So I'll just apply it to every single keyframe now. There's a line here, which basically means this is the movement between these two keyframes. Let's watch it now. Looks way more realistic, right? And now I'm gonna take it a step further and show you how to animate hair. I changed my resolution to the size of my screen, by the way, so we can see the hair a bit better. So if you apply the same technique we just learned to the hair, it'll look really strange and stiff. That's where using rotation just isn't enough. So what I'm gonna do is add puppet pins. For the hair to move, you need to add at least 2 pins. I have 2 pins now. And if I take this and move it, let's see what happens. It makes it swing around and it looks way less stiff than before. I like to add a 3rd keyframe right in the middle. What that does is you can adjust how wiggly the hair is. Don't move it too much though, it'll just look broken. Now we just have to add the keyframes. And we're starting with the lower one. So at the start, at 0 seconds, the hair is pointing left. And now we want it to swing around. So at 1.14 seconds, it's here. And the same amount of time later, you're just gonna move it to the left again. And after that, you're gonna move it to the right again. Now you can see the lower part swinging around, kind of wiggling around. Now you're gonna do the same thing we just did with the middle keyframe. What you can see now is the hair looks a bit more dynamic than before, but it still doesn't look that flowy. The secret to animating flowy movements is not to move all the keyframes at the same time. If you animate, for example, hair, it's not like this. It's not a simple movement. You kind of want this. That means that the middle part is gonna come first and the lower part is gonna come after. And then the middle part is coming first again and the lower part is coming after that. You're just gonna take the keyframes of your lower part and move them a bit to the side so they can appear a bit later. Still looks really strange, right? Because we haven't edited the curves yet. So I'm just gonna quickly put the curves in there. And now with the curves, that's basically it. That's basically how I animate. The very simple basics. I'm going to do a full animation process in the future. But that's it for now, and I hope it was helpful, and thank you for watching. See you next time.